Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. There's no doubt that we have entered the month of Sha'ban. And the word Sha'ban came from the Arabic word Shu'ba. And Shu'ba literally means a branch, because goodness branches out from it. And that's why the month of Ramadan comes immediately after Sha'ban. So the question remains, how do we prepare for this noble and blessed month? There's no doubt that planning for Ramadan begins before Ramadan, as the famous quote goes, that failing to plan is planning to fail. And Shaykh Abu Bakr al-Balkhi, he had a beautiful saying in regards to planning for Ramadan. He said, شهر رجب شهر الزرع وشهر شعبان شهر سقي الزرع وشهر رمضان شهر حصاد الزرع. He said, شهر رجب, which is 2 months prior to Ramadan, is the month of planting. And the month of Sha'ban is the month of irrigating and watering what you've planted. And the month of Ramadan is the month of harvesting and reaping what you've sowed prior. So he's teaching us that planning for Ramadan actually begins 2 months prior to Ramadan. Now the question remains, what about those who haven't planned anything before Ramadan, let alone 2 months prior? Well, the scholar said there is a way out, don't lose hope. For the first 10 nights of Ramadan are your planting, and the next 10 nights are your watering, and the last 10 nights of Ramadan are your harvesting and reaping what you've planted. In other words, make every single day and every single night count in this blessed month of Ramadan. As for some practical tips and practical pointers on how to prepare for Ramadan, among the things we can do starting from tonight is to stand up for Qiyamul Layl. Even if it's something small, for the best of deeds, as the Prophet ﷺ said, أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلَّ. Those deeds which are adwam, يعني, they are consistent from da'iman, they are consistent, even if they are qalila, even if they are small. So let's, inshallah ta'ala, from tonight, pray 2 rak'at tahajjud, just 2, and then cap it off with 1 witr, that is it. If we can just do that and be consistent, then inshallah ta'ala, when we get to Ramadan, we have something up our sleeves. You can imagine, for example, a person who hasn't done any training all year. And when they get to the grand final, they put all of their efforts and exhaust everything in the opening 10 minutes. Of course, they'll be burnt out. They won't survive the rest of the game. Well, that's the parable for many Muslims in Ramadan. They haven't done anything all year. And then when they get to Ramadan, they exhaust all of their efforts in the opening 10 nights of Ramadan. Thus, they are burnt out. You don't see them throughout this noble month. And they may show up again for the 27th, hoping to catch Laylatul Qadr, and then they go back to sleep again, and then they wake up again on Eid, and they go back to sleep, and you don't see them again until next Ramadan. Allahu musta'an. Now this is not the way of the believer, but rather, think of Ramadan as a 300 meter dash. Think of it like a race, where you start off slowly, gradually, increase speed, pace yourself, so you don't collapse before the finish line. That's how Ramadan is. Let's prepare starting from tonight. And also, when we get to Ramadan, as we said, let's not exhaust our efforts, but rather, let's increase and improve slowly but surely. And that's the idea of Laylatul Qadr. The opening ayah of Laylatul Qadr, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ, Allah Azza wa Jalla is teaching us that the best of books was sent down to the best of men, via the best of angels, on the best of nights, to the best of places, to the best of nations, and the best of generations. This surah is teaching us to be the best of the best. Thus, when we try to attain Laylatul Qadr, we should be at the best and peak of our worship. In other words, the last 10 nights, teaching us not to burn ourselves out in the opening night of Ramadan. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to deliver us to this blessed month and to enable us to prepare for Ramadan, a great and solid preparation. Jazakum Allah khairan for your attentive listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.